What screams dumb person trying to act clever? When they use big words they don't know the meaning of to make themselves sound more ambidextrous. Dude, I know what ambidextrous is. I just don't need energy from the sun though. When they just repeat the same phrases about a topic they hear elsewhere and can't explain what do they mean with that. Nervous sweating teachers. If you call them out on something they've said and their instant response is, I was being sarcastic, it was a joke. It usually means they were being an unjustifiable piece of garbage. When they mistake manipulating you as being mentally superior. The phrase, do your research. I agree, but also disagree. Sometimes it is such a widely known topic that they should know it before speaking. Other times I think, I am not your teacher, especially when males talk about women's bodies. Parroting something you read on Reddit or Wikipedia but clearly don't understand. Like that kid in high school physics who keeps dropping one-liners about quantum physics. No one is buying it. Calling people, sheeple, because they disagree with you. An unfaltering lack of self-doubt. Stupid people will often try to act wise by giving out advice, without realizing they still sound stupid. They also often speak slowly and use grand hand gestures to make what they're saying sound important. But the advice will be like, when you send a letter, always remember to put the stamp on the envelope, because if you do not, the postman will not deliver it. Asterisk sits back and nods wisely, asterisk. Always speak in abstracts, can't apply their knowledge to the situation. All information, no meaning. It's like someone just memorized the right sounds to make without actually speaking a language. This is very true. I had a boss where if you took a specific complaint to her, she'd say some abstract crap like, well, the thing is, we're a team. Or, at the end of the day, it is what it is. She couldn't say anything concrete, she just said catchphrases like that as if they were deep. Anti-vaxxers. When writing a show, book, game that's supposed to be smart, have high-level mind games, they instead just write random out-of-nowhere plot twists that go against all previous characterization, foreshadowing. Things like Stephen Moffat's seasons of Doctor Who, Danganronpa V3, and Death Note all come to mind of works that are entertaining when you turn your brain off, but completely fall apart when you use your brain for just a moment. I don't know about you guys, but normally it's my mouth and vocal cords. R. Politics. R. I am very smart. Parroting Fox News points and then can't respond when probed for further explanation. Opposed to parroting CNN news points and then can't respond when probed for further explanation. See the trend here, saying more while listening less. Zhu talking loud and saying nothing, James Brown. When they try to use big words but don't know what they mean, like this one girls I knew once said in Spanish class, I do not know the luminescent to your question, but if you give me a few moments I'll get right back to you. I could care less. When they say that they aren't dumb. Or brag about their IQ. Intelligence is like wealth, those that have it don't need to mention it. Someone makes a ridiculous argument, you tell them to back it up with facts, they reply, Google it. I shouldn't have to research it for you. Trying to convince coworkers that the earth is flat. I'm just eating my lunch minding my own business. I really don't have time for this right now. Reciting definitions, saying what an acronym stands for but they don't know the meaning behind it. Persona. You're not a biologist. Stop acting like you know how to use CRISPR. Person B. Yes, I do. Persona. Okay. Tell me what it stands for. Person B. Clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats. Persona. How does it work then? Person B. Asterisk hesitates, asterisk it's this cluster of proteins you add to cells at short, equal intervals of time. Then you repeat the process. Persona. Yeah, you clearly don't know what you're talking about. It's a protein plus guide RNA that can allow you to delete or replace genes with precision. CRISPR sounds like something you'd order at a chicken joint. The first answer to most AskReddit posts. 9-year-olds on social media spamming the insults, L, and, clownface. I have too many sources here to mention. My response to that is, give me 3. Well, typically in any particular instance of judging one's intelligence, superfluous assumptions can be made which serve to negate the possibility for objective judgment less than, people who type shit like this. Anything on R, conservative. anyone taking themselves or their opinions very seriously. Intelligent people are happy to learn and take themselves lightly, quoting the pop culture versions of Machiavelli or Nietzsche rather than what they actually said. People that use buzzwords. Wouldn't buzzwords be a buzzword? This reply would be a much better example. Cognitive dissonance. What? This violates my cognitive dissonance. You must have misread the question. Smiley face. I have a friend, nice guy, mostly, extremely Christian and Republican and second generation immigrant. Says things like, dude, it's increasing expotentially. He uses malaprops pretty regularly, it cracks me up. Constant interruptions with roundabout talking that don't address the topic. Misusing big words or generally trying to talk above their vocabulary. Judging others' intelligence based solely on their less successful attempts to be seen as such. Tucker Carlson. You mean his dumbass concerned expression doesn't make him look smart? Donald Trump. On mobile, sorry for the bad formatting. I play paintball and there are two types of guns: speedball, which is a gun that can shoot from 15 ball to something like 30 to 50 ball a second, but there can be normal gun and max they can shoot like 6 balls a second. So my friend was going on and on how his gun can shoot like as fast as a speedball gun. Well, Jake, that is not how it works. Saying, I'm a pro at Overwatch, and then picks Bastion as if he required skill other than positioning. Very specific one. Never heard anyone claim to be good at Overwatch and play Bastion, lol. When someone says, Google it, because they don't actually know what they are talking about. People who use their religion as an explanation, excuse for something. Anyone who says the phrase, let me play the devil's advocate. Just about every remotely positive thing you can say about Nazi policy can be undermined by the ideological reasons they were even doing it in the first place, racial supremacy. Not to mention that said positive thing does not require the rest of Nazism to work, so who cares if Hitler enacted some of the earliest anti-smoking laws, and the state ran a feeding and nutrition program that ensured the German youth were among the healthiest in Europe at the dawn of WW2? Whereas the first batch of, say, British draftees were relatively sickly, scrawny boys, asterisk. Any country can do that. What beneficial things could Nazism offer that a more benign system couldn't? That's right, nada. During the act of conversation, your acquaintance has the desire to speak overly sophisticated words as so to paint the image of themselves excelling in the field of mine, even though it does not support their stupid argument. People that say, utilize, because they think it's the same word as, use. The people I read about on Reddit who think that they can trick the IRS with some ploy that they have thought up. Apparently they don't understand that the feds have already seen it all. Keyboard warriors using the word, audacity. It's so overused that they ruined it. I'm from the UK and had a coworker try to explain to me that he has a custom stock price feed for the price of copper. Jackass actually thought he sounded clever and didn't realize you buy copper as a commodity, not a stock. They talk about hot pancake tech buzzwords. You ask about them and can't break them down, or if you ask specific applications with the new fancy tech. They can't tell you anything new that you know and tell you it's complicated and I wouldn't understand. Okay, calling everyone else stupid, ignorant, but not having the information, or practical application of information themselves in regards to an opinion of something. Academia speak, horribly pretentious. I was taught it. Dove in for a bit, realized how assholish it sounded, and swore off it. So far, so good. My Reddit profile is basically the definition of a dumb person. Go look at it. But are you trying to look clever? Dave Rubin. It's insane that Dave and Jennifer Rubin are both tied for stupidest person online and they aren't even related. What a cursed name. Talking about an absolutely popular issue but just about the most recent event, and nothing else, and they have a formed opinion that is absolutely from someone else. Their arguments can't hold for too long because they just read it the day before, at most. I'm smart. Anyone who corrects spelling, grammatical mistakes or other, no one cares, really, errors in a phrase. Asterisk grammatical. Overuse of big complex words, using mostly opinions instead of facts. Usually put too much emotion on a simple subject. Avoiding a topic that they are uncomfortable with that goes against personal beliefs. constantly trying to change the subject to something they are comfortable with no matter what the conversation is. Any thread about bad movies where someone posts, the room lol. Speaking shit with authority. We all know someone like this. They have read a few Reddit posts, often only the headline, and now they're an expert on finance, or psychology, or how to run a semiconductor corporation, or whatever it is this week. Their personal theories are assembled from hours of musing, which they think is just as valid as actual expertise. And they're the same people who are never shy about interrupting a conversation to tell you their opinion. I'd give my right hand to be ambiguous. Someone wiping their butt with wet wipes to save money on a bidet, but then clogs his drain pipes and renders the toilet unusable while also filling his house with a satanic stench. Yeah, dude, once I solved five faces of the Rubik's Cube. Starts quoting Bible verses, using the word, legitly, instead of speaking like a human. This one's pretty minor, but saying, whom, when, who, is correct. If you don't know the rules, just say, who. If you say, whom, where it's correct, you might sound a little snobby. If you say it when it's not correct, you sound like you're trying to be snobby. Posers often don't know when making a mistake is acceptable. Hardly anyone I know, smart or otherwise, answers, how are you, with, well, though it's grammatically correct. Doing so sounds stiff and uptight, or like you're recovering from an illness. When people boast about their achievements and skills during a discussion in which those things aren't applicable in any way. Asterisk clever, technically correct, the best kind of correct. The rampant misuse of reflexive pronouns. Jim and myself, if you like chocolate like myself, quote quote dot dot dot, a nice man such as yourself. It's as irritating as inserting whom, wherever, who, properly goes. Or people who were once told that they shouldn't say, Jim and me went to the store, so now they only use, I, and say things like, this is important to Jim and I. Though, to be fair, I often fuck it up, when thy persona uses thy exquisite words. Even furthermore whilst utilized in such a fashion that it doth become incomprehensible due to blatant misuse of said exquisite words. Well, what screams clever person acting dumb? My tactic in school is playing dumb. I just act like I know what I'm talking about while making it blatantly obvious to others that I don't know what I'm talking about while also secretly actually knowing exactly what I'm talking about. I mean, that's a triple layer of deceit. It even works. Someone getting a gold on Reddit for some random joke. Claiming crap like, I can identify where any item is from, or something. They're going to say some random garbage thinking you'll have no way to prove them wrong. A person leaping at logic. I knew that. Posting on Reddit. Me on Reddit. When they consider themselves part of a sliver of humanity that is intellectually gifted, and think the average person to be a dull-witted brute. Correcting effects to effects incorrectly. False equivalencies where the things being compared aren't even close to being in the same ballpark as each other. Most recent one I saw was people upset that the cop who shot Ashley Babbitt isn't being charged while being enraged at the thought of a cop being charged in the death of any number of unarmed black people. A person screaming, dumb person trying to act clever. If I was any fictional character I would definitely be Rick Sanchez. Asterisk year. Assholes in corporations who use the latest corporate buzzwords each year. Using bigly words like kofifi. I am actually very knowledgeable in quantum, insert random subject. Did you know XYZ? Where'd you learn that from? There's a 50-50 chance they know it's not a good source or they don't remember it. Using, I, as an object. Checking my posting history, me. How do you know it's real them? I saw it on TikTok. Gets information from a single shady and or biased source and suddenly acts like they know all about that particular topic. Well, one time I said, more or less, and my friend said, stop trying to act clever, you're not clever. So yeah, all of Twitter. When they use, due to the fact, in speech. Australia's PM. A coworker of mine tried heating the ice cream dipping sauce, or whatever it's called, by pulling up the steel jug and placing it in a microwave. There were sparks. When they pretend to understand things and when they are asked about it can't explain how it makes sense. One sentence actually. When you tell them something and they try too hard to make it look like they already knew what you told them. Usually they try to repeat back what you said in smarter sounding words.
Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.